And the crazy thing is there was another guy that you're going to learn about a little bit later named John Ott. And you know what he was famous for? He was Walt Disney's animator that did time-lapse photography. Okay? I don't know the movie. You guys may know the name. But it was in 1971 he came up with it. And he had flowers that he showed grow and do all different kinds of things. Turns out that he made some key investigative slides for Disney and dropped it, but then he took it to the medical boards and different physicians who let it go by the wayside. And what he found is that when he took plants and he put them in different light, the chloroplast molecules rotated faster than not. Then he decided to do it on animals, and he found out that one of the cells in the eye called the retinal pigmentum epithelium, which you're going to hear about shortly, at the base of the eye has melanin granules that absorb what? UV light, because it's made out of those things that we talked about, rotates faster, and guess what it makes? What Ruben talked about, a DC electric current in the eye. So that means you can regenerate tissues when you have a high DC electric current. Isn't that right, Ruben? Didn't Becker tell us that? Isn't that interesting? He went even further, and this is probably one of the most counterintuitive things I'm going to tell you. This is a picture of people's pituitary glands who were blind and who could see. What did he do? He went the extra distance. This is what I want you to focus in on. Light slows, energy is lost, the pituitary gets bigger. When I saw this, I immediately realized that everything in medicine was completely ass backwards. Why? Why did I say that to you? Everybody in this room, except the people that heard me talk last year, believe that people get fatter because they eat too much. Turns out it's exactly the opposite. So I'm not going to ask Ruben this. I'm going to ask somebody who I don't know. You, I don't know you. All right. When you sprain your ankle, does your ankle get bigger or smaller? Okay. When you have heart failure, does your heart get bigger or smaller? Okay. Just so you know, he said it gets bigger. Here's the third one. When the star in the sky dies, does it get bigger or smaller? It gets a red giant. So everything that loses energy in the universe gets bigger. What did Hallwych tell us? Hallwych showed that when light slows, the pituitary gets bigger. You know why it's getting bigger? Because light is getting turned into chemicals that you call hormones that go in to the nuclear DNA to change it. Guess what that means? That means light is capable of altering DNA. It also means that light is capable of potentially reversing my previous problem. Meaning that when you're obese, maybe your main problem is you're not getting enough sunlight and it has nothing to do with food. How's that for a shocker? That's what Fritz Hallwych taught me. So I didn't believe any of this. And most of you may not know this, but I went to medical school at LSU. And there's a very, very famous ophthalmologic researcher named Nicholas Bazan, who's done incredible work. And you know what he's cut his teeth on? DHA. He's like the DHA guy in the world. And I learned this back in 95 through 99 when I was there. He taught me a lot of crap. And crap that I thought was crap, because it wasn't important to neurosurgery, but 12 years ago it became extremely important. To me right now, it's huge. And the number one effect right here in this central retinal pathway between the clock and your hypothalamus, you have two loops in the eye. One loop's called the short loop, the other one's called the long loop. And what it does, it recycles DHA constantly as light comes through. It's coupled to vitamin A, which you're going to hear about later, and I'm going to tell you why that's important. But the key thing that I realized, Bazan taught me, that this central retinal pathway and the retina had more DHA in it than any other part of the brain. And I thought that was bizarre. Then I realized why. When I started to learn about physics, remember the guys who came out with GPS devices, Garmin devices? Well, it turns out that the clock here has to run faster than all the other clocks in the rest of your body. If it doesn't, it doesn't work. So if you have an iPhone and you use it to go to a restaurant here in Vermont, the clock that's up in the sky, up there, has to run 38 microseconds faster than the one in your iPhone. Otherwise, you're going to be 100 kilometers off. That would not work. You'd wind up in New Hampshire. It wouldn't be good. Well, it turns out in your eye, the exact same thing happens. And the reason why DHA in the eye is important, because this DC electric current runs faster than every other part of your body. That's the reason why DHA is important. And it turns out, when you have too much blue light, because blue light is the antidote for vitamin A and for DHA. Do you know why? What kind of light makes vitamin A? Anybody want to guess? You heard somebody talk about it earlier. Blue light makes vitamin A. How do you know? Is there any artists in the room? What's the complementary color to blue? Yellow. And guess what? Vitamin A is yellow. Isn't that a shocker? That's the link between this. Light frequencies control the level of vitamin A in the eye. It also, every opsin in the body is tied to retinol, to vitamin A. There's not an opsin in the human body that's not tied to it. That's the reason why, and Chris is here so he can verify this. He wrote a very nice blog post, I don't know how long ago it was, that there's data from NHANES that when you have deficiencies of vitamin A, it's tied to obesity. And nobody has told you why. I'm telling you why right now. Because you're blue light toxic. Blue light makes you fat. Okay? Really fat. And it starts right here. And it ruins this Bazan effect. And the crazy thing about the long loop, the way you recycle DHA, this is the way it works. When photosynthesis makes it in the sea, in plankton, it's mostly in the SN1 and the SN3 position. You heard Ruben talk a little bit about this earlier. Well, SN1 and SN3 get changed when the fish eat it and the fish change it to SN2. What does SN2 mean? It means that it becomes planar, like a semiconductive plane, which is important in the eye. That's the reason why taking algae when you're a vegan is idiotic, because there's not enough in there. You need the seafood to make the molecular change, okay? And there's papers out there that show that SN2 is the only thing that gets into the central and peripheral nervous system of eukaryotes, which everybody in this room is. So guess what? That was another piece of the puzzle. So we knocked that one out. I went back and looked at this. The reason why this is not equal is because light, the evolution of light, does not equal the evolution of our retinal anatomy. I started to put this together pretty quick. Then I started to look at sunrise and sunset. When the sun rises, you have visible and infrared light. You don't have any UV initially. But guess what else happens at this time? You don't need your rods and you don't need melanopsin in the morning. So guess when they regenerate? They regenerate in the AM. Guess what else happens? You actually make melatonin in your eye in the morning. The hormone of darkness is first made in the human body in the eye. In the morning, when you have a combination of UVA and infrared A light. And the reason for you is what I told you before about the aromatic amino acid that absorbs that. And you see that UVA light doesn't show up here. So for the guy last night, who I don't know who you are, but asked the question, how am I going to do this as an executive and fix my life? This is the key. You need to reconstruct your AM to fix your real problem. And that was what I had to do to my surgery schedule. That's why I stopped operating at 7 a.m. Started all my cases at 8:30. It's also the reason why I moved to the 28th latitude from where I lived. Why? Because UVA light shows up. Now, you guys here that live in Vermont got some bad news for you. If you've got a mitochondrial disease, which most diseases are, you need that UVA light. And it shows up later here than it does in New Orleans. So guess what that means? You need more control of your life in the morning than any other time. That's the practical advice, okay? These are not Jack Cruz's rules. These are the sun's rules, okay?